Good morning, children.
Today we are going to see the next subtopic, that is meristematic tissues. In the last class we have studied, you know, that plant tissues are divided into two, meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. So today in detail we are going to study about meristematic tissues. Okay, I told you that day that meristematic tissues work is they are always busy in what? Cell division. Okay, so cells of meristematism or meristems, or it can also be called as meristems, okay? Cells of meristems, they divide continuously and they help in increasing the length and girth, okay? When they divide like that, no, they help the plants to grow as well in length as well as in girth. That is the first point. And the second subtopic is characteristics. When we think about a person, we will immediately think about the characteristic features, no? When you think about your uncle or aunt, no? Immediately what will come to your mind? She is very good. She is having a full of helping nature. She used to do this. She is good in cooking. She is good in the, like, the characteristics, it will come to our mind. Same way here, before studying about meristematic tissues, we will study about the characteristic features, okay? The first thing is, cells are similar in structure. Structure-wise, they are of same. And they have cell wall. What cell wall? We have studied plants have cell wall. Animal tissues, they do not have cell wall. So they have thin cell wall that is made up of cellulose. Okay? It is made up of cellulose, first point. Shape, if you see, they may be of spherical, oval, polygonal or rectangular in shape. Okay? They are compactly arranged. There will not be no intercellular space. What do you mean by intercellular space? One cell will be like this and here one cell will be there, some space will be there. No, there will not be any intercellular spaces, it will be like this only. There will be no space at all. Okay, they will be together. So, compactly arranged, no intercellular space. Each cell contains a single large nucleus. We know that in a cell what will be there? You have studied, no? One nucleus will be there. So they have a large nucleus and dense or cytoplasm. So each cell is having a large nucleus and dense cytoplasm. Vacuoles may or may not be there, because in other tissue, other cells, if you see in plant cells, they have a big vacuole. But in meristematic tissue, sometimes it may be there, sometimes it may not be there. Okay. So some important points about characteristics of meristems. See this diagram, I have drawn a plant, okay? This is one plant. And I have located the meristems. We have studied three types of meristems. What are those? Apical meristem, intercalary meristem and lateral meristem. Apical meristem, name itself tells that is in the apical. So here I have given only the shoot part, so I have shown it here. If I have shown the root, no, the tip I would have shown what? Meristem. So here in the apical tip, I have given apical meristem. This brown color thing, no? That is apical meristem. Intercalary meristem means, see here, this is one branch or one leaf. So, this portion. In this portion, what will be there? Intercalary meristem will be there. Lateral meristem, you see, in the stem, in this portion. Okay? So, these are the three positions. Now, we will see what it is. So, apical meristem, intercalary meristem and lateral meristem. Okay? First, we will see apical meristem. Apical meristem is situated in the growing tip. I told you, you know, it is seen in the growing tip of stems as well as roots. Okay, they are also found in the apices of leaves. In the leaf tip also, what will be there? Meristematic tissues. Which meristem? Apical meristem will be there. So, they are seen in stem, root and in the apices of leaves also. In the growing tip, not everywhere. What is the use? It helps in increasing the height of the plant. Okay? It is only helpful in primary growth, not secondary growth. Once when it is growing, no, that is called as apical meristem, primary growth. So, it is situated in the growing tip of the stem, root and also in the tip of the leaves. It helps in increasing the height of the plant. Okay? So, primary growth will take place. Next, we will see about next, we have written intercalary. So, we will see intercalary meristem means they are located at the base of the leaf. See, this is one leaf. Base of the leaf I have shown, or in the internodal region. See, the base of the leaf, or this is the internodal region, no? this is one node and this is the other node. In between the places there, no, that is called as internode. So they are located at the base of the leaves or in the internodes, okay, stems of grasses and monocot plants. We have studied, you know, two types in angiosperms. Angiosperms are of two types, dicot and monocot. So this is a monocot. Monocot means in the grass and all, if you see that stem, no, it will be having what? Intercalary meristem. It produces an increase in the length of the organ. If you see, for example, one stem you are taking, one leaf will be here this side and one leaf will be in the other side. In between gap will be there, no? That region is called as internodal region. If it is not growing and if it is seen near, how it will be? It will not get that length, no? So, it produces an increase in the length of the organs. Which organ? In between the leaves and the internodes, that space will be there, no? That is because of intercalary meristem. Okay? Lateral meristem. Lateral meristem, if you see, they are found beneath the bark. What do you mean by bark? Dog's bark. That bark? No. In the trees and all, if you see, one brown color outer layer will be there, no? That is called as bark. You have seen. So, they are found beneath the bark and in vascular bundle. Have you seen vascular bundle, how it will be? I will show it to you in the next one, okay? Vascular bundles of dicot roots and stems. Okay, this you keep in mind, vascular bundles, I will explain it to you. In vascular bundle, xylem and phloem will be there, I will explain. So, they are found beneath the bark and also in the vascular bundles of dicot roots and stems. The second point is, it causes the organ to increase in diameter. Okay, in diameter or in girth. So, this will help in length, this will help in girth. Okay. So, we have studied the first point, they help in increasing the length and girth of the plant. So, apical meristem is helping in length and this is helping in girth and this will help, or this will also help in the length. Okay, in MCQs if they ask, no, you should be able to explain. And functions, always there will be some function, no. Quickly we will see five functions. This meristematic tissue is the parent tissue, okay. From this only all other tissues will come. So, these are parent tissues. It means formation of new cells. Okay. From the parent tissue only, formation of new cells. And I told you that in case if you pluck a leaf, there is some injury. After 1 month, if you go and see, there will not be anything like that. Who is doing that repair? Place of injury is healed by who? Meristematic tissues. Okay. New leaves, flowers, branches, fruits, root has new things which are coming out of the plant, no? It is all because of meristematic tissues. And shoots, they are not growing like this. They will grow upright, no? It is because of meristematic tissues, okay? This is just an information about function. Parent tissue, they give form to new cells. So, they help in the formation of new cells. They heal. If any injury is there, place of injury is healed and all the new small leaf, small fruit, small flower, small bud, all the new things, no? Who is responsible? Meristematic tissues will work on it. Shoots are made up of growth, shoots are made to grow upright. Okay, this is about meristematic tissues. It's very simple, no? Okay, so first meristematic tissues characteristic features, then you should go through this diagram, apical meristem, how to draw, intercalary and lateral, and then the three different types of meristems, apical meristem, intercalary meristem and lateral meristem, and also five important functions of meristematic tissue. Okay, keep studying. Bye.